Later today, Justice, you snot-nosed punk. Let me tell you something. I have a major, I'm telling you, major surprise for you. Just you wait and see.
Actually won a World Series game last night.
Well, we'll see if that holds true tonight, I'll tell you that. But uh-oh.
Little farther away.
Uh-oh.
Oh,
no.
It's a beautiful day for me.
Fashion statement himself.
Oh, the greatest manager in NPWA history. It is the greatest day for me. Let me see the bike.
This should probably be my first jacket.
All right.
Yeah, I think so.
Like that.
I'm not down here to talk about
nice
how
jams,
I got
by the way.
Hey, man. Singles. There's a little
fly in the
ointment
in I'll this
league.
I'll tell you something about this guy.
Justice.
Last week, if you recall, we had Mad Mike
just
here.
Down.
We apologized for a little bit of the audio problems we had last week.
And
Mad Mike was here.
Do
and
I have a
and Mad Mike had
justice.
It on there. We're
going to
hear from Mad Mike
me
later on about
and
that.
And the way we were
but
checking this guy out.
Got
oh,
he's
going to wipe
that.
Justice out.
Maybe
inflicted of the
a little bit of fines.
I definitely believe that's right. I can't leave his hands
before
off anything
before I introduce
here.
Him.
But then
let me
I
tell
guess
you,
Justice
this
got
guy's
involved
so
with Sonny D with back
he
there.
Might take
Justice,
out
according to Sonny D, sucker punched him as well. So now he's talking.
What's this?
There we go. He's got Justice out here.
What are you doing interrupting my
out there.
TV time? You got someone that
no
can take me
on?
On
the ground,
oh, I got something to take you on. Let me see that mic. I got someone. I got the biggest
come
man
come
you
come
ever
buddy.
Faced.
Come on, right here.
Let me
yeah.
introduce. To you and to everybody out there in the NPWA, my new acquisition,
uh-oh, new man.
From Camp Lejeune, Major Clark.
Major Clark.
Boy, you're gonna get it now.
What is this all about? I've never seen him
just
before.
Just have one thing to say to you, you're going down. You're gonna be beat. You're not gonna wrestle nobody.
Must be
no
to the ultimate chair.
I'm just gonna put you in a hospital.
Why is that?
You're done. Your wrestling career is over.
Look at
wanna go?
They both forced
let's go right
in the
now.
Ring, I guess.
Let's go.
That's a USMC tattoo on Major. We got a challenge here. Believe it or not, we got a challenge.
This guy knows how to sledge.
I wonder. Camp Lejeune. Sergeant Sledge, a brother of justice. Rumor has it, Sergeant Sledge, very close to a return. Very close. But after the being set back a few weeks ago by the headbangers attacking the G-spot, we don't know. Here we go, we got a referee, we got a match.
Wow.
On schedule.
On schedule.
While we got a break in the action, I'd like to remind you fans, we've got highlights of the Cauliflower Alley Club coming up after this matchup. We've been talking about it for 2 weeks. The big banquet that they had on October 5th, NPWA was a part of it. We'll show you some highlights from that. And of course, the Samurai takes out the Ninja Warrior. Second match of the series of three. Here we go, that far.
Come on now.
Right in the nose.
See that?
Wow, Major Clark's gonna have a broken nose for sure.
Hey, he's gonna have a Jim Harbaugh, that's for sure.
Wow,
look at his blood now right there.
Oh, nice reversal by Major Clark. Major Clark has some wrestling background, I take it. Matter of fact, somebody just told me he does. He's the high school wrestler, collegiate wrestler, I believe. Probably wrestled down there in wherever. Looks like Marine. I don't know anything about this guy. All I know is Sonny D's very solid. Gorgeous guy. I don't think any guy could come into the NPWA without wrestling a match and defeat a man the caliber of Justice, that's for sure.
So much for what you think. I don't know. This guy looks like a newcomer. And certainly Justice looks to have the upper hand in this matchup, but you never know. The tide could turn at any time.
Almost connected squarely with another one of those rights. Look at this.
Justice got to stay away from fighting this guy. I do believe this guy is going to be a little more crazy than he is.
Uh-oh. Referee goes down. Next. Oh, boy. Now the referee's down. We're lucky to even have a referee for it. This wasn't even planned this week. But anything can happen here on NPWA Wrestling.
Pop with the chair. Oh, here's Lady in the head.
Sonny D goes down.
Oh no, my friend, Sonny D, come on, get up.
Mad Mike's friend too.
Mad Mike's best friend.
Got the chip. That's a way to put Major Clark down and out.
Sonny D back up. Mustn't have hit him very hard with that chair. What is Justice doing here? I mean.
Oh, he should have followed up a lot better.
Picking him up, I mean, there's nothing going on over here.
The referee's back too. Justice hits the ropes. Breaks the count.
You know, Justice doesn't make any sense. He's walking around kicking people. It's not wrestling.
You take him under your wing.
Please. It's not good enough.
They're locked up again.
The only thing you kick when they're down is old ladies. That's the only thing I kick when they're down.
Stop it. Flying clothesline by Justice. I think he connected him good with that.
Yeah, he did, but... Oh, well, I was going to say he's hurt too, but I guess not.
Rolls over. The pin?
I blew the shoulders up.
He counted three.
Oh, come on. That shoulder was clearly up.
Sonny D thinks so. There we go. There we go.
Sucker punch. Again.
2 weeks in a row, huh?
Oh, man.
Well, let's go to the replay here and see. Here's a punch. Man.
Right on the nose.
That'll make you look a little uglier. That was a chair. Wow, Justice.
Shoulder area up there.
Justice didn't come here to play around tonight. He didn't even know he was wrestling, but an impromptu matchup.
Look at the shoulder.
Yeah.
That is clearly up. Look at the ref. Oh my God. He needs glasses or something.
Tough break for the rookie in the NPWA. Back to live action. Look. I don't think he'll be back in a while.
Up there whispering sweet nothings in each other's ears over there.
Look at this. Sonny D, bring him back to Camp Lejeune. Maybe he needs a lot more training to be here in the NPWA. Not just anybody could go in that squared circle. All right. Well, when we come back, we're going to have...
October 5th, 1996, Newark, New Jersey. The Cauliflower Alley East Coast Reunion Banquet.
What we do now, we break bread, have a sip of the grape, and talk, and have a lot of fun. And what we do...
The Cauliflower Alley Club is a non-profit organization. An
association of past, present, and future champions, contestants, and allied personalities joining in recognition and celebration of fellowship within the boxing and wrestling world.
Tom Rice.
The NPWA was on hand in order to take a look at the festivities that took place on October 5th. One of the honorees, Tony Casanza, was inducted into Cauliflower Alley Hall of Fame. Perhaps a familiar face for those of you familiar with the historical background in professional wrestling, Dominic DiNucci was inducted into the Hall of Fame. Captain Louis Albano, of course, became a big hit at the Cauliflower Alley Banquet with his boisterous announcements as he announced and inducted Afa Anoya into the Cauliflower Alley Club. And Afa, better known as Afa the Wild Samoan, who made up the Samoan tag, was very soft-spoken, as opposed to the man who gave him his speech ceremony into the Cauliflower Alley Club.
In fact, he's there too much sometimes.
Who could forget the Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, a legend in his own time, and still active today. He was inducted into the Cauliflower Alley Club. If you're familiar with the Massachusetts independent wrestling scene, a man who runs that organization, Killer Kowalski, and his IWF, inducted into the Cauliflower Alley Club. A surprise inductee, a surprise to even himself, was to Mr. Perfect, Curt Hennig, who was recognized for his accomplishments in professional wrestling and also for his future in professional wrestling, as we know a big comeback the other day. But Mr. Perfect, Curt Hennig, inducted into the Cauliflower Alley Club.
Because the good times aren't over for good, believe me.
Jim Cornette can't be my star.
Another surprise inductee was from the WWF, Sonny. Sonny was inducted into the Cauliflower Alley Club for her accomplishments thus far in the world of professional wrestling. But the top honorees went to the McMahon family. Vince McMahon Sr., a man who was a legend in promoting wrestling along with his father and his son right there, Vince McMahon Jr., who accepted the award on behalf of Vince McMahon Sr. But not only did Vince McMahon Sr. get inducted, Vince McMahon Jr. right there was inducted by many of his close friends and respected by everyone in Cauliflower Alley for all that he's done in professional wrestling, where many speakers went up and expressed their opinions of Mr. McMahon and how he's helped them with their career. Vince McMahon was expressed in many stories from many different people in the club.
I'm going to say that because I work for him. I'm barely working anymore. I retired, about 6-7 months ago. And with Vince McMahon, I got to know his family. And I must share that with you. Most wonderful family that anyone would ever want to meet. I mean,
Vince McMahon's wife, Linda, was asked upon to give a speech for her husband.
We got married. That he would always love me, and that life would never be dull.
Vince McMahon's son, perhaps the fourth generation of promoting in the McMahon family, took the speech for his father, thanking him, his grandfather, and his great-grandfather for all the things that they've done for wrestling over the past decade.
My grandfather was. It was a very emotional day for me. I really don't have any words other than to say that I love you so much, and I know I can't wait to follow, hopefully, in your footsteps and get into the business and make it the greatest success ever.
But not only was Cauliflower Alley a place to hear the stars, it was a place to meet them as well.
About the McMahon family, my dad, my grandfather, Shane, and hopefully Shane and Loretta, many other little McMahons soon come along.
doing segments for the Conan O'Brien Show as its co-host, Andy, covering the event, asking questions about the presidential election. There he is with Sonny. And of course, from the NPWA, the NPWA champion, Hot Body Brown, was on hand to endure in all the festivities himself. And there he is, meeting and greeting with some of the inductees into the Cauliflower Alley Club Hall of Fame banquet. There he is with Sonny of the WWF. With Afa, the Wild Samoan. Mr. Perfect, none too pleased about meeting Hot Body Brown, it seems. And the top honoree of Cauliflower Alley Club, on behalf of his entire family, Vincent K. McMahon Jr. So on behalf of the entire Cauliflower Alley Club, and all of its members, all of its honorees, and everyone who attended, we thank you for having us covering the event with the NPWA. We look forward to joining you once again next year on the East Coast Banquet for Cauliflower Alley, the Ring of Friendship, 1996. Not like he's a manager or anything, but he brought the Ninja Warrior in to settle the score.
A man like that, he doesn't need a manager.
Who is that man? I mean, everybody's been wondering as of late. It's been the talk in the locker room. I mean, seeing just newcomers coming into the NPWA everywhere. Some of them are very, very impressive. This man's one of them. He's a samurai.
I got a feeling he's not a newcomer. I got a feeling. I know who he is.
From the Shaolin Temple, weighing in at 280 pounds, the Samurai!
Here he comes.
Well, we definitely know who this is.
All right, fans.
It's Scott Oresco, who will be paying attention to the game tonight. Definitely a Yankee fan all the way. Got the interview.
Rematch. I can't believe you lost the first match to this man. What's your game plan for game for some second match?
Well, it's all a thing about respect, man. I saw the light belt around his waist, and I figured it was going to be no contest. I was wrong. I have much respect for the man now. We're even doing opening kata together. What happens, happens. This is going to be a true test of martial arts. And I hope I can come away with it.
All I have to say is this man is not a white belt. When I seen that first match, I don't trust him.
Hey, come on! It's a half-hour show here!
Hot body, watch your samurai.
Quiet down.
He's right, though.
Good luck to you.
Quit your whining.
It's time.
Scott Orozco, take your toupee off and have a seat.
Toupee? He's that young to have a toupee.
Yeah. Come on, bald.
From what I heard from the samurai, I take it we're going to have an opening kata, a martial arts kata where.
Welcome back?
Well, no, not. That went off the air about 20 years. Well,
sorry, I.
Unless you get those channels that play that. Let's see what we got here. Are they going to do this in sync or what? I wouldn't surprise.
They're going to do it in the ring. Why would they do it in the sync?
Never mind.
I don't understand you sometimes. I really don't.
Yeah, I know. I speak way over your head sometimes. Look at that. Oh, no. Lightning Warrior is.
They're doing the Macarena.
I wouldn't be surprised if something like that ever happened in the NPWA, but this is a kata. A kata. Those familiar with the martial arts know exactly what I'm talking about. And very good. All right. And we're ready to go underway with action in Gorgeous Gary. Look who showed up. Mad Mike.
Oh, no, he's sitting right over here to my right. I didn't even see him.
Mad Mike is here.
Here he goes.
What is on your mind this week? I know last week you had a lot of problems in the back with some of the personalities like Sonny D ever since they did that, what they did to you, but...
Yes, there were problems.
Well, let's give us the scoop.
Well, Commissioner stepped in and levied a few fines to all those involved.
Okay.
And just to show his dislike for Sonny D today by beating Major Clark.
Absolutely.
Go back to basic, Major. As for the Samurai, I've been sitting around his camp with Scott Oresco, just keeping out of sight, seeing what I can hear. And looks like he said, win or lose, he's going to unmask the Ninja Warrior.
Today?
Today. Win or lose. Everybody wants to know who he is.
How come he didn't say that in the pre-match interview?
Well, let the guy know he's going to unmask him.
That would be most interesting, but the Ninja Warrior is having all the offense thus far and doing very well, just like last time, 2 weeks ago, in the first matchup.
Samurai's been under training 2 weeks. Man goes through a change in 2 weeks.
All right, well, Matt...
He better change in 2 weeks, otherwise you're going to start smelling.
He could. That could happen, yes. You would only know about that now, would you?
Uh-oh. Ah, thank you, Matt Mike, for always being on top of the information scene here in the NPWA.
Look at this. Look at his replay here. We're going to have a replay on this. Ninja Warrior with down on his head. Look at this. Slow motion besides. Hey, oof.
Well, that's got to hurt.
Ninja Warrior, he's coming back here. He's going to live action again after this replay.
He was for the Yankees did Sunday night.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah, but last night was a different story, Gorgeous Gary.
Hey.
I don't want to see that chop coming my way too much longer.
Let me tell you something. They better pray. They better pray. If they don't win tonight, it's over for them.
Well, don't touch that dial. The NPWA Wrestling is on.
The Ninja Warrior.
Half hour comes to us. Forget about that game.
The game's not even on yet. So just keep it right here. Watch us.
That's right. Hot Body Brown throwing in his words. And Ninja Warrior ducks underneath the Samurai. Samurai got the Ninja Warrior up and down. I'll tell you, Samurai is not playing around. He's very vicious this week after what happened last week.
And if you lose to a guy who's a white belt, you'd be upset too.
Got a ringside camera working very well this week. You can check out some of the action here. Side view.
Are you female audience members? You can see the cute squishies of the PWA.
Wow! What? Ninja Warrior comes.
You see that one? Holy, I don't believe it. What was that?
The moves that you see in there are such a different style from the martial arts. This is more like your basically all martial arts. There's very little wrestling involved here. Warrior is down. Samurai. Very even matchup, I take it. It's been back and forth. I don't know if the Samurai loses, his chance of beating Hot Body Brown are over, because that's what this match is all about. If Ninja Warrior can beat him.
I think he loses every single round.
Oh!
I think he loses title consideration if he loses this match. This man's not even ranked.
Oh, come on. Well, the Hot Body said, I'm in to beat you, Samurai. You're not getting a title shot.
You blame him?
Samurai has been camping a way more than deserving of a title shot. I've never seen a challenger get ducked for so long.
Please, he came and beat a white belt.
Where's the Ninja Warrior going? He's going all the way to the outside, and... What is this? Up the... Oh! That would have been something.
I think it took too much time, but that was one heck of a move there, huh? Carl, what do you think? What do you think?
I've never seen a move like that in my life. It would have been something if he connected. This match could have been over. The Samurai got out of it. He got away the clothesline, did he not?
I think so.
Went over the clothesline.
now. Samurai got him down. Two.
Not putting his shoulders clearly up. He's just rough and tell when his shoulder's up.
Not Buddy Brown thought so. Where's the Samurai going? He's going to the outside.
Too much time.
Samurai to the top. Is he going to jump? It could be tough. Oh, he got him.
God, I cannot believe it.
260 pounds down out. Uh-oh.
But he's not pinning him. What's going on here?
Uh-oh.
Oh, that's a major mistake.
He gave a signal to lift the mask off, and he's trying to pull it off. Injured Warrior's not letting it happen.
This could be a big mistake by the Samurai here.
We might just find out who this Ninja Warrior is. Hot Body Brown, he's trying to block the camera view, I think, or something.
Exactly what he's trying to do.
Fighting off goes the Ninja Warrior. Why is he trying to hide his face? That's a big mystery. Why is he trying to hide it?
Well, it's a psychological advantage he has. You don't know who he is.
I thought for sure we'd see something.
Look, guys, you know, you don't know who he is. You could be dressing in a dressing room and some guy you don't even know could come up to you and go help you. You don't even know who it is. Oh, or maybe he's just really, really ugly. I don't know. Could be one of the two.
I don't know if he's as ugly as you. So he has something to brag about.
Gee. Thank you there, Bronson.
Off the top, the Samurai.
He caught a leg, but I think he got it in his ribs, too.
He caught him. Uh-oh. Hey! He got the mask! Look, there's Hop. The mask is off Hop Body. Look, they're running out of here. Who is that guy? He got hit. I don't believe this.
I did not get a good enough look at that to see who it was.
Samurai's in the ring. He's got the mask, and we got a count out.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner.
What a cheap victory right here.
Hey,
what a cheap victory.
A victory is a victory. Samurai walks out with the mask and a Ninja Warrior, and maybe we'll get a replay with our rings. I don't know. We got to get a replay or something. Get a better look from a different camera angle. Here we go. Some of the action earlier on.
Nice kick to the face there. I thought it took too much time here.
Off the top, this is where he pulled the trigger. Wham! Ooh!
My buddy Brown upset. Can't blame him here. Look at this.
This is where the mask came off. Look at that.
Okay, I'm trying to get his knees right away. How about he's getting in there?
Covered him. He put something over his head and they took out of here like bandits. Look at that. Ooh, is that? Well, next week, Gorgeous Gary, we'll have the final match since it's tied 1-1. Ninja Warrior taking on the Samurai. Justice will be here. Genghis Khan will be in action. We'll have much, much more. So, for Gorgeous Gary Johnson, Mad Mike also gonna, we'll sign off for him since he's not here. I'm Bill Bronson, saying so long for now. Gorgeous Gary, any last words?
Bye-bye.
Original. We'll be right back.